10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Since the splitting of the atom only a few decades ago, and through his God-given genius of science, man, at last, has succeeded in penetrating further and further into the unknown vastness of space. The moon has become the launching base for advanced exploration. From this pivotal point, astronauts, at the risk of their lives, set out to conquer nature's mysterious forces. Yet many questions remained unanswered. What is his Earth in relation to the inconceivable number of other worlds? Is his speed truly the fastest, his achievements the greatest, or is he a mere unimportant piece of driftwood floating in the vast ocean of the universe? Could there be life similar to our own on other planets? Is it not possible that atmospheric conditions of relative environments control their shapes and forms? If so, would they be giants, or could perhaps the opposite be true? Could their intellect have reached a scientific level far above man's dreams? What then will the future reveal if this story you are about to witness is only the beginning?
Log entry, Pegasus 3, March 16th, 1980. Captain Leonard Pilot, Lieutenant Webb Navigator. This is the seventh and last day of space reconnaissance research, Flight 361, from United States Air Force Lunar Base 1. We are 21,000 miles from base, bearing at 270 degrees, 23 minutes. Azimuth at plus 46 degrees, 46 degrees, 50 minutes, ecliptic. On routine successive approximation by trajectory computer using data from the space position recorder. It's quiet and lonely out here. And frankly, we'll be happy to get back to that dreary old moon.
We're almost a degree off trajectory, Captain. Equipment check's okay. Must be an outside acceleration force. Something approaching fast. I'm setting up auto-evasive pattern.
A large planetoid object is on a direct collision course with us.
We are under 11 G's exterior acceleration and have no control whatsoever.
Thank you. It's just incredible. Two ships missing in less than a month. Nothing within thousands of miles of their position. And yet they crash into something that appears suddenly on our radar, big enough to be a planet. And then the next instant it disappears.
It's against all theories of space.
You get the same reports from bases 2 and 3?
It appeared for a second or two, then vanished completely.
A ship is on a routine flight. Controls, rockets, everything in order. And then all of a sudden...
Yes?
General Gibson for Colonel Lansfield from Earth headquarters.
Stand by.
Colonel Lansfield.
Lansfield, what's all the trouble up there?
General, I can't tell you any more than what was in that report this morning.
You're certain the rockets crashed?
I am. We have their last log entry through our recording reproduction unit. Now, General, I've listened to it over and over. It tells what happened, but not how and why.
What do you suggest?
I don't know, General. No doubt the rocket's destroyed. We don't know what we're looking for. This mysterious planet seems to come and go at such speeds, it's impossible to track.
Phantom planet, Lansfield. You're a little old to think that, aren't you?
This is a capable base, General, run by capable men. Now, there's something out there that isn't supposed to be.
All right, take it easy. Send another reconnaissance with Chapman.
Chapman? I need him for the Mars project.
If this phantom planet thing isn't cleared up, there won't be any Mars project. Send him.
Yes, sir. Ask Chapman to report.
Yes, sir. Captain Chapman, report to the Colonel.
Sir, I've been testing the pressure equipment for the Mars project.
Forget about that now, Chapman. You leave tomorrow morning. The General wants someone with your experience.
I don't know whether to feel flattered or not. What exactly will I be looking for, a floating space monster?
This is no joke, Frank. I wish it were.
Sorry, sir. You know how rumors move around the space.
Well, it's one of the things we hope that you'll dispel.
Well, you're the Colonel. I'll take a crack at anything once.
And that's about all you'll get, Frank. One crack.
Miles out at 270 degrees azimuth and 47 degrees ecliptic. Speed 4.6 miles per second.
Check. Computer guidance on. Stability course on. Directional rockets port off. Directional rockets starboard off. Set to automatic.
Check. That does it, Captain. We can relax a bit now.
Takeoff's always the same. My heart pounds like a sledgehammer.
Yeah, mine too.
How about the screen? Never fails to fascinate me from up here.
You know, Captain, every year of my life, I grow more and more convinced that the wisest and best is to fix our attention on the good and on the beautiful. If you'll just take the time to look at it.
Yeah, some guy, Makonnen.
Lunar Base 1 to Pegasus 4. Lunar Base 1 to Pegasus 4. Can you read me?
This is Pegasus 4 to Lunar Base 1. This is Lieutenant Makonnen.
Colonel Lansfield for Captain Chapman.
Chapman standing by.
Anything out there, Frank?
Nothing, Colonel. It's almost too quiet.
Well, keep alert. And don't waver off your course 1 degree, unless you think you're on to something. And if you do get on to something, report at once.
Yes, sir. Pegasus 4 to Lunar Base 1. Over. Out.
I hope whatever was out there is gone now.
What's our elapsed time from base?
14 hours, 22 minutes, and 30 seconds.
You could stay up here another 14 hours and still see nothing. Even 1,400 hours.
That's about all we can do, though.
You sure we're still on course?
Why?
Well, I have an idea. Turn to 278 degrees azimuth. 047 degrees ecliptic.
Yes, sir. Changing course to 278 degrees azimuth, 047 degrees ecliptic.
Lansfield tells us to charter the same course Pegasus 3 took. Well, that's fine, but I don't think we'll get anywhere. If this strange planet dashes about like it's supposed to, it figures we won't find it around here. So we're changing course.
Lightning never strikes twice in the same place.
Precisely. You with me?
Like I said, you're the captain. I'll take a new reading.
Thanks, Ray. You could go nuts out here just waiting for something to happen. You seem pretty much at ease.
Well, I figure it's just the same as fishing. You've got to be patient and wait.
Electrostatic meters going haywire.
Lunar Base 1 to Pegasus 4, can you read me? Over.
Pegasus 4 to Lunar Base 1, we read you. Over.
You are completely off course, Pegasus 4. Check your position immediately.
E-computer and spectrometer out.
Pegasus 4 to Lunar Base 1. We are aware of being off course. Cannot explain at present. We are entering a heavy magnetic field. Several instruments are out and I'm afraid others are going. Give us our exact position. Over.
Pegasus 4, you're...
Cannot hear you, Lunar Base 1. Over. Changing to the manual control.
Meteor!
Boy, that was close.
Yeah, and I'm afraid it isn't over yet.
Course with them.
Screen one's fading fast. What about the infrared detector?
That's out too.
The thing we can do is turn it 90 degrees to the shower's path. More meteors are coming, it's our only chance.
That will be to 311 degrees azimuth and minus 12 degrees ecliptic.
Here they come.
This is it. Now, those are ionized trails. They'll persist for a while.
Well, let's hope for those tracks.
With these instruments out, there won't be any way to tell if they're coming from another direction.
The trick now is to get back to the moon.
I think we'll make it.
Yeah. Okay, Ray, let's go through a type B check.
Right.
Cabin pressure?
20, coming up.
Retroport?
Positive.
Better starboard.
Positive.
Main circuit one.
Negative.
Main two.
Negative.
Now let's try the auxiliaries. Main one.
Negative.
Main two. That's not in the circuits.
Well, the meteors must have smacked into the propulsion elements.
Our feed lines.
Yeah, we're lucky.
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Looks like it.
You know, there's one thing sure.
What's that?
They knew what they were doing when they forced us to go through those space drills dozens of times.
If I remember correctly, you had a different opinion.
Okay, don't rub it in.
Thank you.
retro rocket feed lines must be cut.
Respect to the colonel, sir. I don't think it's any use.
Keep working that radar and keep working it until we locate Chapman.
Yes, sir.
He's got to be out there somewhere. He just has to be.
Lieutenant Makonnen.
Captain Frank Chapman, pilot, Pegasus 4. My ship is being drawn toward an asteroid. Instruments completely out of operation. Navigator Makonnen, lost. I cannot read my position. I'm going to try to land. I don't think I'll make it. If I do, I'll continue recording.
1 to Pegasus 4. Can you read me?
Frank, your airline's broken.
Navigator Makonnen.
Frank.
Lieutenant Makonnen, I'm going to try to land.
What exactly will I be looking for? A floating space monster?
No joke, Chapman. I wish it were.
Trial. You must take him to Cecil.